Okay. I'm just gonna. Hello. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Beautiful people out there. How are we doing? I hope everyone's doing an amazing. I hope everyone's having an amazing time. Alright, so. Why did I just go on live? I saw through the grapevine that a couple of people were very fortunate enough, 안녕하세요, were very fortunate enough to get the Dear Insanity pre-order. So yeah, I heard people got the pre-order pretty early. And as we all know, the album's coming out in 4 days, I believe. So, for all the lucky people out there that got their hands on the album first, there was technical errors that happened, so you weren't meant to get that for until the album release, I believe. But it is what it is, right? It is what it is. And first of all, hope you're enjoying it. Hope you're absolutely loving the album, because because to be honest, I haven't even got the album myself. And I've been seeing it pop up here and there. So it's not a deliberate leak, no. We'll never do that. But for the people that got it, for the people that have it in their hands, for some of you that are too eager to listen to it and have already listened to it, good on ya. And I just hope you enjoy the songs. Like, that's all I could say. I just really hope you enjoy it. And for the rest of everyone, let's try not to spoil it. Let's try not to spoil the songs, just for everyone else, you know. So if you guys could just do that for me and not spoil it, not yet, just in a few days, maybe in a few days, maybe it could be here and there, but in a few days, we'll definitely listen to it together. So, no, it's hard. So just for the viewers here, just for the people that in the chat, who has, who's got it? Can I see a show of hands or show of letters, if I say so myself. Hello, hello, darling. How are we? Did I sleep well? I slept very well, dear. And I think I've been sleeping really good these days. I've been tip-top shape, currently editing. And for the people that are coming to the meet and greet, or I guess the album signing, I can't wait to see you guys in New York. So make sure to bring your best smile. And even if it's not your best smile, you could just tell me all about it when I see you guys at New York. But again, so this, for the people that have the Dear Insanity album first, I hope you enjoy it. I really do. And like I said, I think things are meant to happen for a reason. I don't know what was meant for this, but 앨범 너무 기대 중이에요. 감사합니다. 저 약간 프리오더 하신 분들이 미리 지금 오늘 받은 사람들이 있더라고요. 보니까. 근데 그게 약간 어쨌든 좀 어디 쪽에서 약간 좀 실수 뭐 이렇게 좀 그게 잘못돼 가지고 오늘 받은 사람들이 있어요. 근데 뭐 그건 어쩔 수 없으니까 스포일러만 안 하면 될 것 같아요. 나머지 사람들을 위해서. 근데 아무튼 anyway, so yeah, that's pretty much that. And just I'm pretty excited. I can't believe the album's coming out really soon. And I can't believe... oh my God. There's just more surprise. I don't think I could say it. I don't think I should say it. But there's... Yeah, I shouldn't really spoil it. But there's a lot more. Something... It's I can't really put it into words. But I'm really excited about the next couple of months. I guess you could say. Hi, John. John just joined. So yeah, so everyone that's coming to New York, can't wait to see you guys. It's gonna be, it's gonna be a while since I've really stepped out. And as you can see, my hair is growing out rather long now, and I'm definitely gonna try keeping it long, and I'm not gonna cut it this time. That's what I always say, but I promise, this time I am not going to cut it. LA, I think we might even do one in LA. I don't know. Because I did one in LA last night for Mitre 2. And the turnout was amazing. And I met some amazing people. Your birthday is in 10 minutes. Well, happy birthday in 10 minutes. Pookie, come to Austin, Texas. Am I your Pookie? I've never heard of that before. A Pookie. That sounds like a dog's, like a puppy's name. Pookie. So yeah. What's up? How are we doing? Yeah, I've been good. I've just been so occupied with this music video and a couple more things that I think I had no time awareness that I was going to go to New York in a few days. And not just that, but the album is coming out soon. Thank you. This is the obviously the cross, and this is a very special gift because this was given to me by my mother. So for me, I don't like to go too religious into my talks, but I've always gathered that, you know, as many of you know, my name, DPR, it's not plus, it's a cross. It's Cross Ian. But I've always thought it, you know, kept me safe and it guarded me. So my mom gave it to me on my birthday. And on the side of it, it says, I'm not sure if you could see, it says Mitre on the side. So it's a very safe pendant for me, and not a pendant, but it's obviously the Christ. But like I said, I have a lot of good, many references to that in my music videos and such, because I see it as a symbol of protection for me. And my mom was very kind enough to give this to me on my birthday, so I'm going to probably wear it for the rest of my life. No. Hello. Yeah, so for people that just came in, if you've got my album already, congrats. And just hope you enjoy listening to it. I do need to shave. I haven't shaved in a couple of days. But these days, I feel like a little mustache. It's been growing quite rather rapidly, and I've been good. I've been absolutely amazing. I've been so, I guess you could say, yeah, I've been really happy these days. I think my swings have taken a turn for the better. So, happy boyfriend day. Happy boyfriend day, is it? So, anyway, guys, just wanted to say, super excited for the album to come out. So many more things are in store for you. Come to Japan. I would love to go to Japan. I think we're going to go to a couple of places right after the album drop. So, we have, obviously, Paris lined up. And we have Singapore, I believe, and a couple of more places that I think I'm doing my shows. But I'm super excited to do that, and I can't wait to see you guys. It's always one thing to be working indoors and another to really go on stage and see you guys. But yeah, Dear Insanity is coming out really soon. Stream it, send it to your friends. Hope you enjoy the... Oh shit, I was about to spoil some shit, but no. Come back to Peru. You know what? Honestly, I could go to Peru forever. I love Peru, man. It's just... I love a lot of the... I don't know. Like, I just love traveling so much. I think for me, I definitely loved Mexico as well, because Mexico City, I thought, was so beautiful. I don't know, man. It must be my calling. How can I get the album? Well, I think if you go to my link in my Instagram, there's a link to all the information for the like where you can pre-order it and order and all that. So it's all down there. So if you go to that, then you can see it. Latin America is full of tasty food you would like. Absolutely. I love me some Mexican food. And I love Peruvian cuisine. I think that's one of my favorite cuisines. I think Peruvian dishes are just one of my favorites. I've never had a bad meal there. So, and obviously Indonesia. I love Indonesia. I mean, we just got back. It feels like an eternity, but it was like a couple of weeks, I think, that we just got back from Indonesia, and I had such a blast. It was so much fun. So, Atlanta, man, I think I went to Atlanta once. I think that was for the tour. I think we went twice. Yeah, Bali, I've never been to Bali, so that's one place I definitely want to go. Oppa, 좋아해요. 저도 좋아합니다. 감사합니다. So anyway, guys, just wanted to say that, and I don't know what else to talk about. Do I like Singapore? Of course I like Singapore. You know, a lot of these places that I've visited, I don't think there's ever a place that I didn't like. I don't think there have ever been a place where I visited that gave in a bad experience. I think everywhere that I went to, relatively, I was very fortunate enough to have quite the experience, and I really had a lot of fun. Come back to Seoul. Oh yeah, you know what? I love to do that. If you ever take a break, you should go around the world and do a food vlog. You've read my mind. 100%. That's exactly what I was thinking of doing. A food vlog. Hell, I was even thinking of opening up my own restaurant. You know, how's that? Your own DPR restaurant. And it's like you get to experience the food with, I don't know, I'll try to make it more of an experience. Obviously, the food tastes good too. Would you go to that? Would you guys go to that? Sydney. Oh my God. You know what? I think I'm going to make a trip to Sydney pretty soon after the album release. 제발 해드릴까요? 제가 진짜 나중에 식당을 해가지고 식당을 열려고요. 그 식당은 근데 뭔가 좀 다르게 할 것 같아요. 뭐 어떻게 해야 될지 모르겠지만 근데 뭐 요리하는 걸 되게 좋아하니까. I love food. I don't know how we went to the topic of food all of a sudden, but I really do enjoy food. I love eating. Who doesn't love eating? I've been eating good these days. I've been trying to eat healthy. Occasionally, I'll do. I love McDonald's. For many of you that know me, obviously you guys know that I love some Maccas. And for me, it's always a triple cheeseburger. But I just realized in you couldn't do that in Korea, but in here in the States, you can literally add extra patties and extra cheese and whatever extra. So that was mind blowing to me. So for me, when I found out I could make my triple cheeseburger into a quadruple cheeseburger, I was kind of like the most happiest person alive. And not only did I get one, but I got two. So I usually eat two quadruple cheeseburgers. That's usually my go-to meal. Let come to Bali with you. I'll, darling, if you could take me anywhere, I would be more than happy to go anywhere with you. Quadruple. Yeah, you know, I don't know, for some of the OG fans out there, they know that I've been eating cheeseburgers ever since I can remember. But I used to eat about eight double cheeseburgers on average. Can you believe that? I used to eat about eight double cheeseburgers on average. McDonald's DPR collaboration. Oh my god, sign me up. I'll do anything. Oh yes, and Abu Dhabi, I think. Oh my goodness, I'm so excited. Gosh, there's, come to think of it, there's quite a few places we're going to perform. I cannot wait. And it's going to be a first for me for some of these places. So, can't wait to see the dreams out there. What would you have in a DPR Happy Meal? You would literally get a Mitre figurine and a DPR Live special action figure. And his spaceship. Yo, can you imagine that? You get a DPR Live spaceship and maybe possibly the green and maybe the Mitre and Insanity in different eras. Can I just say, this album, Dear Insanity, is literally about the story of insanity. That sounded so bad. My mind went off into a million things just in a split second. Maybe I do have a serious case of ADHD. On the whole crew. What weight is no blueberries for sure? You like no blueberries. No spoilers, please. 100%. Anyway, so. Oh, and come to London. Darling, I think I will be quite close to it. You know what I want to do? I want to just, after all this is done, I just want to go and backpack and just stay at a lot of these places that you guys are mentioning, and I just want to have fun. I want to go out, I want to eat some good food, meet some good people, go to some crazy places, who knows, get drunk responsibly, even though I don't really get drunk, but we, you know, actually maybe I do get drunk. But I think I'm going to do that. I think I'm going to go backpacking. And just as someone mentioned earlier, I might have to do a food vlog here and there. Give my unprofessional critique on how it tastes. Not that you guys want to hear it, but I'll just mention it anyway. How would I describe the new album? That's a good question. If you're expecting Mitre, the sound of Mitre, you'll have hints of the sound of Mitre, but as I mentioned before, Insanity is a completely different part of me. So in terms of that, it means this character is influenced by a different sound as well, a different genre. It obviously still has the essence of Ian, but I'm going to continuously cater to characters and profiling them with certain sounds. So, it's always going to be Team Insanity or Team Mitre, you know. But for the most part, it's going to be a forever ongoing law. And when you get the two fused, you get a very interesting line. So yeah. Would you record again in Peru? I'll record anyway. I think that was one of my favorite places to have recorded anything. I think that's where I kind of started getting the passion to travel. I think it was when I first went to Peru and Cusco. It was just so mind-blowing, and I think I'll never forget that first moment where I just kind of picked up everything and left, and I went by myself, and it was just amazing. Can I be your dog's veterinarian? Of course you can. If you're a good vet, then yeah, you're always a friend to Lori. What's my favorite song on the album? I think it's Changes. I think my favorite song on the album, but then it's gonna be quite, it used to be Welcome to the Other Side, but it's just because it meant a lot to me at that time. I love Don't Go Insane, but I also love Violet Crazy. So it's a good ending song too, so. Did you go to college? I believe you're trying to say college. I went to uni. I went to Sydney Uni. Not for long though, because I didn't even finish first semester, because I went to Korea. But I did get in, and I said I'll come back, but I never did. Mito Lego Brick. Is that like a special edition Mito Lego thing? Because I'll get that shit. Mexico. Sorry, the comments are going so far. Which career? It was for science, believe it or not. So you could understand why it wasn't for me. I studied science. I was rather good at math and all that, you know. Maybe it was the, you know, my mom was a professional math teacher, so she taught me at an early age and, you know, got the upper hand, and I was good at it. It was your typical Asian, good at math and science story. But what I really did enjoy more was music and arts, so it was split. So later on, you know, when I was doing my HSC, I realized it's just, it wasn't for me. There's no point for me going to uni for something that I wasn't even passionate about, and I just picked up and left. I'm not gonna say it's for everyone, but 이과 바로 맞습니다. 어떻게 알았지? 아무튼 저는 그래서 이제 계속 편집해야 되거든요. So I gotta go edit, guys. Can you believe it? So I have to go edit. It was beautiful seeing everyone. Oh wow, the lighting here makes me very, very like warm and nice. So as you can see, I'm oh shit, oh fuck, oh shit. Yeah, I was about to expose what I was editing. Oh shit, it's kind of funny. So guys, I have to. So 가지 말까요? 저 근데 지금 편집하러 가야 돼요. So I gotta. Edit. Actually, you know what? Fuck it. I'll just walk around. You wanna say hi to the team? So you wanna say hi to the team? So in my house currently, we're working with. I have everyone working in the den with me. John's knocked out, is he? John is knocked out.
Yeah, he's passed out.
Okay, so here we have Josh. He's helping. The content. Say hi, Josh. We have John over there. No, John. It's okay. No, no way. And that's Jono.
Oh shit.
He just awoke, and that's Porom Nunas. So say hi.
Hi.
So we have people just constantly working and sleeping in the den and they're working so hard to get this out. And, you know, I just, you know, just without these guys, it wouldn't be what it is. I'm sorry to wake you up, by the way. I'm sorry to put you on the spot like that. So, yeah, guys, I just wanted to introduce you guys to them. And like I said, it wouldn't be the same without them. Amazing. Oh, and here's another fun thing. I got these cakes, and it says, "Don't go insane." I had like two cakes already. I don't think I've ever had a house tour. So this is the island. That's the painting or whatever. This is the drum kit I usually play. This is the master bedroom, but I don't really go there because it's I don't really sleep. But I should. Tired again on there, but I don't really sleep. But I should sleep. That's my. I love that face thing. Peanut butter and tears, and sometimes I just like to put it here. So, right now you guys are on top of a Pizza Hut box. Because I love pizza, and I've told you, I love junk food. I love just chowing down on junk food whenever I can. Maybe it's better up here. Sorry, did I put, is Jonah back to sleep? All right, boys and girls, maybe you can. All right, I love pizza. You know what? You know what my favorite pizza is? So, my favorite pizza, it kind of looks like I'm doing show and tell, but my favorite pizza is Meat Lover's Pizza. And I love the kind where you have a little bit of onion on it, where it's just enough that you get that spice from it. And I like mine from Pizza Hut. I like the original pan crust, because that, honestly, the only crust I would ever stand for is the Pizza Hut crust. I don't like any other crust. I don't like Domino's or Papa John's. I just love the Pizza Hut crusts. But with that being said, I love Domino's. I love Papa John's. I love all of that. Can someone turn on peanut butter and tears? And I love me some peanut butter. Peanut butter and jelly. Peanut butter and tears now. What else do I? I'm trying to think about what I can show and tell, but I don't have anything. Oh shit. Yeah, screw it. I never really took everyone around. But shit, man. Sometimes I think I'm being too dimensional by putting my like Instagram live on just the wall. Say hi, guys. I'm back. You know what's so funny? They were like, I think they were watching the live, and they were watching it, and then they didn't know I would come out and put them on the spot like that, but I did, because they deserve a lot of credit, and the amount of work that they put in to make just this vision come true is just insane. So could never be too thankful, because I am. You guys still watching it? I'm right here, guys. You're watching me from a screen while I'm right next to you guys. You guys could come out here and... Quite interesting. So... So, stream a lot when the album's out. Dear Insanity, if you are reading this, no, wait.
Well, shit, I forgot the lyrics. Anyway, 콘서트 해드릴까요 지금? 제가 뭐 해드릴까요? Oh my god, you know what it feels like right now? It feels like, I've been seeing a lot of these. It feels like those things where people like start acting like NPCs and then people like give them money for acting like NPCs. Have you seen that? I've seen so many people do that and it's so funny. It's so hilarious. They'll act like an NPC. No one knows that? Alright. Sorry, I'm just talking to myself. Sorry. Thank you. So if you felt rather out of it during the pandemic, and you know, I think that was like a big pivotal moment for everyone, especially during the pandemic, because you got so much time and you're being secluded and you pretty much weren't living the lifestyle that you were used to. So it put a lot of people on the spot. And, you know, I know for many, a lot of people that I know, like they got a lot of depression and all that. And I think for me, like, I think someone was mentioning that when I started my whole journey for my artistry with bipolar, it gives a lot of people clarity. And I'm very fortunate enough that it does that. Now, that being said, I can't give you the answers to, I guess, a lot of the problems, a lot of your... So I will say I'm not a very good advocate for mental disorders, per se. However, I've always felt that it was through a lot of the, I guess, vulnerability, the transparency. And I think at the end of the day, my plot is I always find a way to get over my hurdle. Now, for me, if that gives you any type of reassurance, and I think it's relatability, that's what I'm trying to find in certain people. Because I've always found out, for me, when I, growing up with bipolar, I always realized it was more, I think, hard for me to describe it to somebody than to have them really see it through my eyes. And obviously that's true, because how can you see mental disorders? It's not like, it's not a very physical thing. You can't see it. It's not like someone's broken their arms and it's not a very visible pain that someone could see. So a lot of the times, you know, people will see it, undergo it, like they won't see it, sorry. But I mean, I think a lot of the times it was hard for me to translate that or get them to see it through my eyes. So I always thought, man, if I start music and if I start my artistry, I want it to be something that people can find some type of relatability and through that comfort, whatnot. And for me, I think if that's all I can provide for you, then that's amazing. If it does, I've seen it, but if it does provide you with anything more than that, I'm beyond, right? But I will say, I don't have all the answers, and it's not like I'm trying to give you, it's not like I'm trying to tell you what's right and what's wrong. All I'm being is completely transparent. And, you know, I feel like that's something that we, as artists, or sometimes, often, well, I don't know, in my case, lack. And I think for the most part, I always have a very good supportive team, a good support system. I will give you one advice: is you need a very good supportive system to back up anyone that has a certain, I guess, disorder or, you know, whatever it is. But I'll tell you that you need a good support system. If you do not have a good support system, you have to be willing to go out of your way and find one, because that will either make or break you, period. That's all I'm going to say. But I see a lot of comments saying that my music saves you. I'm so beyond. You know what I mean? Every time I see that, it's insane. I can't believe it. I mean, honestly, that's what I wanted it for it to do. But to actually see that and hear that, it's just, I don't know how to feel. I feel very overwhelmed and I feel very happy. and very fortunate to be doing what I do. So, yes. Who is my support system? I have amazing friends and I have an amazing team. And I'm very fortunate enough that they're always the ones to really stick up with my shit. If that's it. Because, you know, for some of you that may know, if I guess when people go into manic episodes, you need somebody to really put up with that. What's that? What's that, Luna? Oh, you want to see? Look, this is the support system. I'm look what she wrote. It says time to edit. See, this is the. I'm being held at gunpoint, ladies and gentlemen. I'm not. No, she's right. I really need to. See, this is. You see on time. Okay. But. Heedy. I'm going out my way and. Thank you for understanding. No, thank you guys for listening. I know it's hard, you know, you don't have to. Technically, that's the thing, right? But to go out of your way and to hear what I have to say or be part of the journey, you don't really have to, right? No one's forcing you to do it. But if it could provide any type of, I guess, service, then I'm more than happy. It's free. Well, technically, what I say is free. Man has to clock into that 9 to 5. 9 to 5? Man, I would be over the moon for 9 to 5. I'm like 12 to 12. It doesn't make any sense. I am 12 to 12. There's no 9 to 5. From your story, I've learned there's things patients endure unpleasant and painful situations. I remember your advice over. Thank you so much. And you know what? You always have to think there is always going to be ups and downs in your life. And for what I've realized is this, you always somehow get through it. You always get through it. Anything else you guys want to say? Before we say toodaloo, I'm extremely happy, guys. I'm more than happy. I'm pretty excited. Your music makes me accept what I'm going through and look on the bright side. Thank you. That's it. That's it. You got it. I'm so happy. Toodaloo. All right, guys. Okay, I really, really have to go back to edit now. Say bye. Yeah. Ladies. All right, guys. Thanks for tuning in. And Dear Insanity coming out really soon. And what is it? Oh, yeah. New York. Can't wait to see you guys. Be at the fan signs. Yeah, I love you all. 너무 사랑하고요. Someone said, why red with the lighting? Because there's only like 3 settings and I think I accidentally stepped on it. It was purple before. But anyway, I love you all. I love you guys so much. 누구예요? 저 아무, 저... Why is it so hard to, why is that so hard to say? That's like the biggest, trickiest question for me is somebody asking who I am. Some of you that know me know this, so I have to cycle through my identities. But anyway, I love you guys and stay happy, stay smiling. Or you could be sad, doesn't matter. It's all good. All right, peace guys. Love you all. Dear Insanity on the way, 4 days. Woo! Alright guys, but for everyone that has it, just don't spoil it, okay? Just don't spoil it. Love you.